There are two fertility pills, letrozole and Clomid. But which one is best? When should you use one versus the other? Find out on today's episode of Infertility TV. In this corner, the granddaddy of all fertility drugs, we have Clomid. First to come to market in 1967, Clomid has been used more than any other fertility drug in history. And in this corner, sassy newcomer letrozole, known by fans as Femara. Letrozole was first approved for medical use in 1996. Almost 30 years after Clomid. Initially used as a treatment for breast cancer, letrozole has only been used as a fertility medication since 2001 and only used commonly since 2006. Both contenders are given as an oral medication. Both can be monitored at home with an ovulation predictor test or in the doctor's office with blood tests and ultrasounds. In match number one, letrozole faces off against Clomid for the treatment of women with PCOS. A massive study of almost 800 women with PCOS found more women ovulated with letrozole, more women got pregnant and delivered with letrozole, with no difference in the rate of multiple pregnancies. The winner, letrozole. Match number two, Clomid versus letrozole for women with unexplained infertility. In a study of 900 women, less women got pregnant with letrozole and less women had a delivery with letrozole. There was no difference in the risk for multiple pregnancies. The winner, Clomid. Your Infertility TV bottom line, there is no universal winner. Letrozole is better for PCOS patients, and Clomid is better for unexplained infertility. This has been a great introduction, but you need to learn more about these and other fertility pills. Check out this video next. But before you go, remember to like this video. If you have questions or an idea for a future episode, leave it in the comments. And you should definitely subscribe to Infertility TV now for new episodes weekly. It's like having a fertility specialist on your phone.